This is Steve Finerty, Chairman of Argent. I hope all of you are doing well and that you're surviving the new social distancing world that we're all getting adjusted to. Candidly, while I long for the days that I can eat in a restaurant with friends or that I can watch a sporting event, any sporting event, it's gone better than I thought that it would. As part of this process of change, and we are in a situation where the world is changing, about 10 days ago, I asked our portfolio managers and our analysts to offer suggestions to the following question. Knowing that we're going to emerge at some point from this crisis and that stocks will rally, but also knowing that it's going to be different, what trends should we be focused on as we select stocks today to best position ourselves so that a couple of years from now we can look back and say, yeah, I'm glad we took advantage of those opportunities when they arose. The responses were really interesting, and I thought we would share a few with you because investment managers need to look into their crystal balls and make projections about the future. And those analysts and managers that do the best job of looking into the crystal ball will have the most satisfied and the most well-rewarded clients, and that's what we want to be part of. So number one, certain trends which are already in place are just going to be accelerated. The movement of advertising from print to digital is happening. It's here. And in fact, we may be witnessing the end of the newspaper business as we know it. Population flows from the north to the south and the southwest are just going to continue. The spread of healthcare to each and every person in this country is a reality. It's happening and it's going to be expanded upon. Consumer demand for convenience, faster deliveries of food, faster deliveries of household goods, faster deliveries of virtually anything and everything are going to be extremely important. And mobile banking and bill paying are here to stay. You know, the bank lobby as we have known it is going to be a thing of the past within a very few years. Number two, some of today's heroes are relatively low paid. Will their dedication and service be better appreciated and lead to higher wages for those in the lower and middle income groups? And what impact does that have on businesses? And who's helped by that? Who's hurt by that? Number three, how will the commercial real estate market be impacted by this? You know, it's great if you're in the real estate market and you can borrow at almost 0% interest. And it does seem likely that warehouses that allow for faster delivery from our e-commerce world should do well. But what about office buildings? Many are discovering that work from home works better than they would have guessed. I am one of those people who's discovered that. So that's a negative, perhaps, for some office building REITs, real estate investment trusts. But it's probably a positive for other things. Networking stocks, those providing cybersecurity so that our data is safe as it gets transferred around. 5G speed, tele-everything. And it should also be good for the makers of the chips that go into this, to all these different things to make it all happen. Will the globalization trend, which was already slowed a little bit from all the tariff talk, will that continue to decelerate? If you look at inventory management in the U.S. in recent years, it's all about just in time. Have the inventory just in time to the store. Now is it going to be just in case? Meaning, will the U.S. and other countries work harder to protect themselves so that they're not dependent on other countries for needed drugs, for medical devices, or for any other essential equipment that we really need to protect our citizens. And finally, will environmental and governance issues gain greater importance? So as we look to the world and we see future concerns, in the past, things like a viral epidemic that we're currently having has been sort of a theory. Now it's reality. So what other things that are theories, think global warming, think clean water, that we talk about a lot, but maybe haven't done as much as we need to, how will that change things? It's going to be a big story, I think, over the next decade. So as you can see, there's a lot to think about as we go through this, and it does impact portfolio management directly. Things are changing. So as we think about things, we'd welcome any advice that you have. We are more than happy to borrow good ideas, take them as our own at any time. So in the meantime, we do encourage you to be patient. We will get through this. We are working hard to try to best position your portfolios. And to always try to remember, this too, just like other crises, will pass. We'll talk to you again soon.